Continuing our discussions on quantum body, today I would like to address the issue of quantum metabolism, which is of course addressed in the book. So in medical school, after anatomy and physiology, the next lesson was biochemistry. And in biochemistry, we studied various metabolic cycles. And in all the lessons we took, metabolism was basically the metabolism of food into ultimately, you know, metabolic end products, sugar, energy, and so on. So for a general audience, metabolism is the engine that keeps your body running. It's the process by which your body turns food into energy and to power everything you do, the energy that is needed to power everything that you do, from breathing and thinking to moving and growing. If you want to explain metabolism for children, then imagine your body is a factory. Metabolism is the team of workers inside that a factory has, and these workers take raw materials such as food and turn them into finished products, energy, to keep the factory running. So for adults interested in health, metabolism is the sum of all the chemical reactions that happen inside your body. These reactions break down food molecules into energy, build and repair tissues, and remove waste products. There are two main types of metabolic processes: anabolism, which builds things up, and catabolism, which breaks things down. For students of biology, metabolism is the network of interconnected biochemical pathways that regulate the transformation of energy and matter within living organisms. These pathways involve the uptake, transformation, and utilization of nutrients, as well as the elimination of waste products. So these are very different aspects of metabolism, and people can also focus on things like metabolic rate, the role of hormones, etc., etc. However, in the book Quantum Body, we go to a different level of metabolism and ask the question, is quantum metabolism the key to disease and aging? And over here, we raise some very vital questions that are mysteries about metabolism that definitely will require a quantum explanation. These are some of the mysteries. How do cells know how much energy they need? How do cells communicate with each other to balance their energy needs and synchronize with one another? What's the secret of the complex molecular machinery that regulates everything happening in a cell? Where is the timer or clock that moves energy through every phase in our body, from sleep to waking to vigorous activity? In the book, we also propose that all chronic disease may be considered a metabolic disorder. We also propose that your own genes are affected by every experience you have and your ancestors have had. And of course, there are important metabolic factors in the human body that we address in the book, such as redox, the rise and fall of oxidation rates, free energy, and acid-base balance. What is really important here at the quantum level is that we don't just metabolize food into energy to power our activities, whether it's thinking, feeling, imagining, doing, acting in the world, sensory processing, motor activity. We, in fact, metabolize every experience. We metabolize emotions, we metabolize everything that we call experience, thoughts, we metabolize the experience of time, We metabolize, and that is probably the most important influencer of how we age, the metabolism of time. As I've mentioned in Eastern wisdom traditions, aging is not counted in the number of years, but in the number of breaths that you take, or in the number of heartbeats. And now we can say in the number of heartbeats that vary from beat to beat, showing flexibility. So quantum metabolism is looking at metabolism at the most fundamental level, where you need to invoke principles like superposition, like entanglement, like non-local correlation, like the uncertainty factor, like a creative opportunity. All these are quantum processes: superposition, entanglement, non-local correlation, the uncertainty principle, the appearance and disappearance of virtual particles as determined by the uncertainty principle, but also the appearance and disappearance of qualia, qualities of experience, as determined by the uncertainty principle. So quantum metabolism is the key to well-being, to longevity, to health span, to self-regulation, to homeostasis, and it occurs at the most fundamental level of reality, which is the smallest unit in which waves of energy and information are emitted, absorbed. And that energy and information is not just the energy and information in food, but in every experience: eating, breathing, digestion, metabolism, elimination, sensory experience through the five senses, motor activity, intentionality, thought, feelings, emotions, relationships, biological rhythms are all regulated at the most fundamental level through quantum principles, which obviously go beyond the physical domain. These principles go beyond the physical domain. They are principles through which awareness regulates body, mind, and universe as a unified experience. That awareness itself is beyond all conception and beyond all perception. And that awareness is who we are. Who we are is nothing that can be conceptualized or perceived, but it makes everything perceivable and conceptualizable. So quantum body is the final expression of quantum metabolism, and quantum metabolism is the key, going back to the source of all experience, is the key to self-regulation. Let me know what you think of this and your feedback.